Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this episode where I show how to use XSLT and how to actually add some CSS grid inside the XSLT. I saw most of the examples on the internet is actually with a plain old table, but now that we actually know how to create CSS grids, then why not use this for the XSLT example where we take some XML, we transform it into HTML, and then in that HTML we will actually place some styles where we actually are using the CSS grid styling to the information there. I'm also going to use XSD because when we're using XSLT, some people actually have difficulties when they're applying a style sheet, XSSD, then they actually have problem with using XSLT, and I think I know why, and I'm going to show this in the video here, how to use XML with XSDs, and that's XML schema definitions. Yeah, let me just, all these words here, let me just tell you what it is. XSLT is Schema Styling Language Transformation, that's what it stands for. And CSS, of course, cascading style sheets, and XML is extensible markup language, and the XSD is the extensible schema definitions. So the XSD is the definition and the rules, the rule set or the template for the XML, and the XSLT is a technology where we can actually transform an XML into something else. And today I'm going to choose HTML. There's no reason for this clip. It was just something I found here that I think looks cool. I was trying to find something with the transformation, and yeah, you can see here we have an egg that actually transformed into a chicken. So that was the closest thing I could actually find. But just let me just show you what we're going to do. We're going to create an XML file, and I'm going to create a spaceship XML file with a spaceship inside as a root element. This XML here. We can actually say in the top here, then we can actually say that we want to use some XSLT. So we can actually apply an XSLT file, and then we can transform this into some HTML. And this HTML, it can actually use some style sheets, if that's what we want to, because it's just normal HTML. And all this is actually done by the browser. The browser is going to transform it. There's a transformer built into all the browsers. So this is the idea. We will have our spaceship over here, spaceship. So that is step one. We create our spaceship.xml, and then we create our XSLT file, and then we create a .css file. Then after that, then we create a .xsd file, because this actually gives, as I said before earlier, then this actually gives a lot of problems that when we have a XSD applied to the XML, then in order to make the XSLT work, then we actually also need to apply this XSSD inside the XSLT file. I'll show you all this, and of course I'll upload the code as usual to my GitHub account, where it can be downloaded freely, of course. So let's just get started, actually. So I have this one here. Here, this is my project. I used this earlier when I showed the grids and the basic stuff there. Let us just create a new folder, new directory right here, and we can call this XSLT, and then we can create a new folder directory called spaceship. Maybe we want to make more examples in the future. That's why I create an extra directory right here. Let us create a new file called spaceship.xml. Add it to Git. Yes, thank you very much. And then we need to start with this XML file that needs to tell our editor or the parser that it's XML. So we start all the XML files with XML, and then version equals to 1.0, encoding equals to UTF-8, because I would like to use my local characters, my local Danish characters. And then I can create whatever I want to create here, spaceship like this. And then the spaceship is going to have a cargo bay, or what do you call it, cargo space, and in there we have some cargo inside our spaceship. Of course we can add a lot of other stuff in our spaceship, but let us keep it simple to begin with, at least. So we have some cargo, and then that could be some slime. I want to use attributes here also to show you how the XSLT works with attributes. So I want to create an attribute here, which is an amount, and then we say I have 120 pieces of slime like this. And we just create some cargo, slime, or what else could we have in our slime? Let's see here. We could have some lasers, and maybe we just have 25 lasers. What else should we have in our cargo spot here? We could have some mushrooms from a distant planet, mushrooms from planets. What else could we have? We could be, well, what else could we have here? We can have a fusion reactor. Fusion reactor like this. Maybe we just have three of those, they're very expensive. What else should we put in our spaceship? We could put some communication, some radio equipment, and a hyperspace drive. We only have one of those, they're really expensive. The radio equipment is very cheap, so we have a lot of that. So this is our spaceship. We have a cargo space. We're not going to add crew members or anything like that yet. So let's just keep it like that. So this is our spaceship .xml. Then let us get a HTML representation of this, because if I open this in a browser right now, open in browser, default, I'll just show how it looks. It looks like this. So we have the XML representation right here. Not very pretty. We would like to see some a pretty page instead. So let us create an XSLT file. So that's what we do now, spaceship.xslt file. Add to Git, yes, thank you very much again. I'm just going to copy a snippet right here. When we create this, when we're using XSLT, we need to start with the, we actually write style sheet like this, and then we take from this namespace right here, HTTP, W3, org, 1999, XSL, transform like this, version 1.0, and then we actually, if we want some, I'm just going to delete this part here for now, because we actually just need this, and then we need to end this tag here. So this is the begin, this is our end right here. Then what we can actually do is we can write XSL, and then the templating definition actually has something called template in here. So if you find the template, it's right there. Then we can use something called XPath. XPath is actually a way to traverse through our through the XML, and we can actually, if I use a forward slash, that means start in the look in the beginning of our document. This is up here. Then if I write spaceship, then I actually put my cursor on my cursor right here, on my path right here. So, and that's what I want to do, because I want to go to spaceship, and then I want to go to cargo space afterwards, and then look at all the cargo. But in the beginning, I would like to put the cursor right here after spaceship. So I'm just going to write spaceship like this. And then we need to can put all of our stuff in here. And here we can actually add HTML. And in here we can have our body like this. And we can also have a header part. If we want to add a style sheet, of course, then we also need a header part like this. To begin with, we can just have some deals. We will have a container deal. We learned about this if we want to use styling grids, then we usually have a class which is called container or grid. So this inside here, this is actually our grid or container. And then we need a style sheet. Let's just add that right away. So I'm going to add that spaceship.css. Add, and in here I want a container class. And this is where we set display, and we set it to grid like this. And then we give a template. So we need to give it a template columns right here. And then we can say we want one fragment and one fragment, because I want two columns here. So I want two columns, one that shows the cargo and one that shows the amount in the cargo. So I want to have two fragments here, and it can be almost, okay, the description should actually be a bit bigger. This is to take up twice as much space as the amount. So it's two and one. Let us play with the gap and all that a bit later. But for now, then we have an item. And I would like every second item to be colored, or would it, does it matter? Yes, it actually matters. I want every child, or that means every second div to be colored differently. Then I write it like this, even. So it means that all even ones will have this styling here. Background like this, RGB. 100, 200, 200 like this. I'm gonna copy all this for all the odd divs, and then I can give it a bit more blue maybe, and a bit less green. The red is still fine. Yeah, you can also give it a bit more red, it's like that. So now we have item, and then that is fine. Dot item, maybe we want to add some stuff, more stuff. Usually I want to add some padding so it looks a bit better, px, 20px. The padding, that's the space around the content inside the cell. And usually I would also like some gap, but let us just wait with that. So now we have some basic styling here. We have a container, we have an item, we have item, and we, yeah. So let us just go use that. So I'm going back to my XSLT file, and this is the HTML that we want to convert the XML to, and that means that now I need to link this. And I have a snippet right here that I can copy. Right here, link, style sheet, types, text, CSS, and then the reference to the spaceship.css. And that means that now I can actually use these classes down here. So that means that now I have this is my header. So here I will write class equals, it's still an item, or maybe it should be just right here. Now it's an item and it's also a header. So let us style it with two things. Description like this. And then the second cell, that is the amount, the number of the stuff that we actually have. And then I would actually like to, then I would like to add all my stuff right here in a loop. And I can do that with the Excel for each, which is I will add here. So this is part of the, this is part of this schema definition up here, part of the transform definition. We have something called for each, and that loops over whatever we want to select here. And because my cursor is already a spaceship, then I can write cargo space like that, forward slash. If I started with a forward slash, that would mean that I would go all the way out to the root, and then I need to also to start with writing the spaceship. If I write two forward slashes, that means I just look for cargo space somewhere inside the XML. But I want to be specific, so I say go to cargo space and then go to cargo. So that means that now it will select all the cargos down here, and then it will actually loop over them. So that is the transformation logic we have right here. It's almost code actually. So, and then here, now it's not a header anymore, so let me just remove the header. Instead of the description, then we would actually like to select some stuff, XSL, and then we want the value of select. And then because right now you can see our pointer is actually already down at the cursor, let me just show, that means our pointer is actually here at the cargo. So that means if I want the content, then I just write current. So that's a little, yeah, you need to know that. So that's just how it is. So remember, write current. Current like this, and that means that then I actually get the text content of my cargo. That means that then I would actually get this part right here. Let's say that there was some child. Let's say there was some child elements down here, like cargo. It could be like what do we call it, box one or something like that, box one, and then we could have some stuff there. Then I would just write box one instead of current, of course. So that is how we select with XPath and in our XSLT file. So let's just write here current. So that so that is current, that is the description. We also want an amount, so let us just find the amount. Let me just check if I'm shading for the text right now. No, I'm not, that's fine. I think I'll just drag it over here just to make sure. So here we have the amount, and could also go to presentation mode actually, but yeah, I'll do that another time. But for now, we want the amount right here. So XSL, again, now we need to some value of, and then we need to select some things. The way to select an attribute, which is what we want to select now, we actually want to select this number right here, the amount equals something. That is with an at, with the at sign. So that means that if I go to my select right here, then XPath for taking an attribute is at an amount. It actually makes sense because at starts with an A and attribute also starts with an A. So it's pretty, it's easy to remember actually. But XSLT, it's very what do you call it? It's very delicate. It's very fragile. You should not, if you just make the slightest mistake, then nothing works. And sometimes it's actually very difficult to get a good console output for what actually went wrong. So usually you just end up with a blank page if something went wrong. That is why it's very important that you actually validate, right click validate, and see that our XML is actually valid. But this only validates there's no errors. It's just validates that there's no errors at all. Then I go to my XML file. Now I want to apply the XSLT file. We need to do that by adding the style sheet in the top. And we can do that with this little snippet I have here. XML style sheet like this, type text XSL, and then the reference to where the file is located. It's in the same folder, so this is the name. And then a version 1.0 is fine. Yes, let us see if it works. I'll just go up to my browser, see how it actually interprets it now. Oh, look, now we actually have colors and we have a grid. This is the first, so we can actually see here that now we actually, we're taking up all the space, and then we have the blue color here as background, and we have the green color over here as the next column. So this is really, really good, right? So that was actually step one. Another thing, I would actually like some gap between the cells. That's why I don't sound totally happy. So I'm going back to my style sheet here right now. Then I'm going to get 20 pixels like this. Then we get a good gap. Let's just check how it looks now. Then we have this gap here. And then of course the header, we could add the weight. We can add some weight to the font up there. So we can add a header like this. Header. And then we can have some font weights. And then we can say bold. We can see how it looks now. Now it's bold, and then all the rows have the normal text weight. This is very cool. Already a huge success. But let us just push the limit a bit more. Let us create an XSD file, because that actually gives a lot of people problems when they're using XSD along with XSLT. It also puzzled me in the beginning. Actually, I was actually stuck for some time. XSD like this. So now we create an XSD file. And again, I will copy a little bit. I'll allow myself to copy some stuff here. Copy. We have the XML in the top like this. Then we define a schema. And then we say the form default is unqualified. That means that I don't need to use any abbreviation for the we don't need to say which schema we actually come from when we are over in the XML file afterwards. And then we have the this is for attributes, so we don't need to give this for attributes. And to an element, we need to qualify them with some kind of short name for the schema. Or alias. This is our target namespace. This is just need to be URI valid. So that means HTTP something as a protocol, and then something here. It's just a unique name. It's not a place on the internet that actually works. Or at least it's not where I have located my XSD file or anything. And then we need to use the XML schema right here. So this is a definition for what is actually allowed and how we should define our schema. And then we have this alias right here. So we have the XS alias. And that's actually it. And then always remember the end tag. So, and what we need to do now we need to create something that actually represents this. So I'm going to copy this just so I can see what's going on while I type this, paste. So that means that we actually need an element. Our root element is called element name spaceship, like this. And we can actually just, instead of using types, then we can actually, in the beginning I would just create it all in one long declaration, but then after that, then I would like to split it out into complex types. but we actually have the element right here. And because we have child elements, because we have sub elements, then it is per definition a complex type. So we write complex type, and then right here we can actually see we have cargo space, and we only have one. We only have one cargo space. It's not a sequence because it's the only one we need. So that means we're writing all, and then we write cargo space. Now we say that we have an element right here, cargo space like this, and the cargo space, it is also, let me just check here, what does it complain about? Can also use a sequence like this, mean occurs one, max occurs one. So that means we want one cargo as it is right here. So that was a sequence, so we always have one of these. The elements is now cargo space like this. And then the cargo space then has a sequence of cargo. That's, we can see that right there. So that is again a complex type because we have child elements. And then we would like to have a sequence like this, and the mean occurs zero. We don't need to have anything in a cargo space, and then the max occurs is unbounded because we can have an unlimited piece of pieces of cargo. It's a big ship. So, and then we have an element right here, and the element name is cargo. And this element here, you can actually say that maybe you would think that it was actually a simple type, but because it has an attribute on it, then this is also a complex type. So it is a complex type, and the complex type, it has some simple content, this complex type here, and it extends the string type like this. And in here we actually have some attributes. We can add our attributes right here, and the name equals amount, and the type is, that could be an integer maybe, yes, like that. And now I can delete my XML. It was just to help me build the XSLT. So this is the XSLT file. It's not pretty, it's not beautiful or anything, and I think I would like to fix some of it. I would actually like to take out all of this like this, then I would actually create a new type, complex type. This type here, I would like to name that cargo type. So that means that then I can go down here to my element, then I can say type equals cargo type like this. And then I can just delete this part here. And we can do that all the way up if that's what we want to. But let us do that in end. We will clean up in end. So now we've created one type, but we should actually create types for all of this down here. We should also create a spaceship type over here. Let us do that in end. Let us just see if I already has broken a lot of the stuff right here. First of all, we need to go to the XML right here. Then we need to go to the spaceship. And then we need to say that we actually want to apply this type. And we need the target namespace, which is this right here. And then because we have located in the same directory, we do not need to tell the parser where the XSLT is located, because it actually also will look in the same folder. So I just need to write XML NS for namespace, XML namespace, and then I can write spaceship like this, and I can say equals to, and then the name target namespace that we had over there. And then I can say that this is our spaceship, like that. Okay, spaceship is a bad name actually. It's a bad, it needs to be short name. SSP, spaceship. So then I write SSP like this. And because we actually have said that it needs to be qualified, element form default qualified, that means that now I need to go and put this short name in front of all of them, like this. SSP like this, colon, 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 SSP colon, SP colon, like this. So now we have actually qualified, we have said which spaceship it actually is that we are using. we're using the spaceship declared in here. Let us just see if it still works. It should be broken now. So let me just go check. Let's refresh. Yeah, now the document is empty. There's an error. And that is because, that's partly because there can be actually be multiple reasons for this, but one of the reasons, the usual reason, and one of the reasons, and the obvious reason, is that we have not declared this this schema in our XSLT file. So that means that if I go here in my if I go up in my parent declaration up here in my style sheet declaration, style sheet begin tag, then I need to say that we actually have something called a spaceship. That means that I need to add SSP in front of all my spaceship right here, and in front of the cargo, SSP colon. And so now we have actually declared and set what kind of type that we are dealing with. And we declare the alias right there. Let us go look how it looks in the browser now. And now it works again. So this is a tip or the trick if you're stuck and you suddenly stop working after you actually applied extensible schema definition. If you after you applied that to an XML and then your transformation stopped working, it's almost always because you forgot to declare an alias for it, and actually you forgot to qualify all of your XPath expressions with the alias, with the schema alias as we have up here. That's very, very cool. It's already a success, but let us go. I promised to clean up the XSD file, so let us just do that. So we go to the cargo space. We will create a new type. Create a type like this. And then we say this is cargo space type. And then we can say that this type here is cargo space type. Like this. And again, we can say that our spaceship, instead of having all this stuff right here, then we can actually say create a new type. And then we can say type equals spaceship type, like this. Oh, name equals to, and then we use the type down here, type equals to spaceship type, like this. And then have a self-closing tag, which is down here. And then I prefer to have my root element in the top, so I'll just place it up in the top right here. So that means right now everybody can see I have a root element right here, and then they can actually traverse down and see. And okay, this is the spaceship type. I'm holding control when I press the name. It has one cargo space. Okay, or here's the cargo space. Okay, nice. It has some cargo type. Let me just go look there. And then the cursor jumps up to wherever it is. I hope you enjoyed this this video. If you liked the video, of course, I would appreciate if you click the like button, and also if you subscribe to get more content from me in the future. I hope to see you again very soon. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.